Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to show you how to make a beat for Pusha T. Now Pusha T's style is like the dark Kanye to the extreme. And by dark Kanye, I'm talking about all those kind of evil horror sounds that Kanye was kind of experimenting with. But he takes it to like the, you know, the extreme. So he's like bouncing out Kanye's sound. So it's not very happy sounding music. And that's the first thing you really need to realize. It's horror-like. So you need to find elements and build elements which are horror-like. So the first thing we want to do is make a horror sound. Let's open up Silenth 1. Let's go to Menu, Initialize Preset. Now we're going to make a short stabby chord. So let's give it a short decay, a little release. And let's go to our tempo. Let's right-click. So we're at about 90 BPM. Let's go to our piano roll. And let's figure out how to build out horror-esque chords. Now, horror chords are more tense chords, and I'll show you how to build tension. Let's start with A minor, for example. And I'll show you how to take A minor into a more tense chord. So here we have A, C, E. And we just want this chord to hit constantly. So it creates a nice rhythm. I did that by accident, but I like that sound at the end. I don't even know how I did it. It went da da da, one, two, three. So we need to change the triplet timing. Let's go to our snap to grid. 1/6 beat, I believe, in this case, or actually 1/3 step. And we need to zoom in a bit so we can get in here. And we have 1, 2, 3. Okay, so here we're going to fill it out. Every two blocks is going to be a nice triplet step. That was an accident, but it sounded pretty good. So let's do that for each chord section here. Let's just copy that since it works. Now I'm going to work on the stab first, and then we're going to get into the actual sound. So right now I'm going to increase the decay and kind of move it around until it gets to a nice length, where it has enough tone, but not too long. Now the release, if I take it down, it doesn't even make a difference. But if I have the release up and a longer decay, it makes a difference. A nice sound. So now let's work on the sound. How do you make this harsh and horror like? You want to think detuning a sound, but very sharp detune. So detuning it, but only a little bit to get that gritty, aggressive horror sound. Let's go with a triangle wave, a higher octave. You also want to think detune manually with the fine tune. Now, a quick way to make chords tense is if you're using, for example, all the white notes or the A natural minor scale or C major scale, you just want to pull notes until they're close to each other. For example, you would either pull the notes A and B because they're close together, or C and D, or D and E. You know, if I don't pull those close together, there's a note in between each of these notes. So it's a nice harmony. When you pull those close, it gives it a different tone. Now I'm going to turn the polyphony up too. Okay, here's the difference. Now, also, moving notes outside of the scale. So here's what we're going to do. A quick way to kind of make it horror-like is just move it up or down a half step. We need to add filtering to kind of make this more of our sound. I'm going to make the filter move. Have the same characteristics as the sound, a very short decay. Now we have a nice horror-like sound. Let's add a little reverb. You can also add a layer of texture with white noise. And this is more advanced, but you want to change this to a white noise pack. Lower the volume. copy that amplitude envelope. Just give it a little more release, a little more decay time. This is for texture sake. Now it's not just a basic sound anymore, it's more unique. You can even make it more aggressive with distortion. Gotta be careful with the distortion though, because it elongates the sound and makes it longer instead of short decay. So I like a nice balance. So let's add this into the playlist. So that's gonna be our core kind of thing. Now I'm gonna work on the sound to make it less synthetic sounding. Let's change our main waveform. Octave. There we go. I like that sound better. I wanted it to have a longer tail, but I also wanted to have its sharpness. Right now it sounds like a synth. I wanted to have a nice short decay. There we go. Now let's go into processing in the mixer. Let's open up Fruity Reverb. Let's give it a very high level wetness with a very short decay. That gives it a nice kind of, we call it a slap reverb. Let's go to our playlist. Now you need to figure out what kind of drums you're going to use. In this case, 808 would be perfect to get that aggressive tone out. So let's find a nice aggressive 808. Let's go with... Now I have my subs on, so that's helping me decide as well. I like the collision. This is a good one, but keep in mind this changes pitch over time. If we right click and go to edit, go to pitch tab, go to detect pitch regions, it changes from F to E. So you have to be very careful how you use this 808. Okay, to tune the 808, there are more steps to it, but let's go to the envelope. Let's reset our root note, and the first note I believe was F. So now it's, let me make sure, I think it was FE. Yeah, it went down. So there's F, and now we can play it like a note on our keyboard. Now what I want to do is have control over the sound. So let's go to the volume. Let's activate the hold parameter. So now when I let it go, it stops playing. And I can create those nice sloppy, har-like 808 slides. Now, on the wrench tool, you can make it more pitch slidey by going to monophonic, activating the slide mode, or portamento. But gotta keep in mind, you want it mono so they don't overlap. So that's how you get those nice bends. Go back to our browser. Let's pull up some X drums. Now the drums he uses are more drum break drums, so you want to look for drums with maybe cymbals over top of them, like this type of drum. Or just think about, you know, making a unique layer with your drums. So I'm going to open up some hi-hats, layer it with the open hi-hat. Let's see what happens here. Let's grab a cymbal for that trap sound. And what else? We need a snare. So we're gonna go for more organic snares, not synth snares. So we're going to go for hard snares. Let's go back to our playlist, insert pattern 2. Now here you wanna create a human-like rhythm. So this goes into many different concepts of ours, but in short, you're gonna use the swing meter as well as the time offset meter here to get a very unique humanized feel. And I'll show you how to combine all those elements to make it more humanized. So let's start with the kick PC. And let's delay the synth. So let's go to our synth and turn up the time shift. Let's turn on the metronome to help us. So it's just a little bit delayed behind the metronome. That adds to the groove as well. Now every song he has doesn't necessarily use drum break drums. So let's go to our mixer and we're going to find the blank insert, which is insert 3. Let's right click, go to channel routing, route select the channel starting from this track. Now everything in the mixer, every sound is accounted in the mixer. So let's just start with the kick and the snare to keep it simple. So the snare feels too early, it feels too computerized. So let's go to the wrench tool and turn up the time shift a bit. You want to really work with the time shift meter. Now also, the swing meter is affecting the synth. So you need to go into the synth, go to the miscellaneous functions, turn off the swing parameter for the synth. So that was affecting the timing. So the snare is actually behind the synth. And that way we can layer the snare. Let's push it back a little bit further. Now it feels like the snare is gripping our attention, pulling us in. Oh, that groove is just disgusting. So let's go back. Come up with a kick pattern. You want to think old school hip hop. So a laxed kick by turning that time shift up, and this is combined with the swing meter creates a very unique drum pattern. So the swing meter as well as time shift is how you get those boom bapish swings. Kick's a little delayed. Bare minimum with the kick, you don't have to do too much. The bass I'm going to add. So I'm using octaves. I'll show you what that means. Very common in 808 to use octaves. So I'm using a high F and a low F. And I'm swinging between the two. And also we're going to have a little lag between the notes, so it makes it feel more sloppy. Okay, so let's go into our piano roll, and we're just going to adjust the note timing here because it's a little early. So let's go to snap to grid none, smooth these over a bit. Also, I don't want the notes to overlap because I want them to sound like they're new hits every time. Changing the sound shape. What we can do is automate the decay. So let's move the decay. Let's go to plugin options, browse parameters, and mod envelope 1 decay. We can create automation clip so that we can tell it to raise over time to give us that kind of belly sound over time. This is what you want to think about when you are creating compositions. You want to maximize the effectiveness of one instrument. Treat it like you would a guitar. You know, you don't play a guitar the same way all the time. Sometimes you strum it, sometimes you pluck the strings individually. So that's how you have to think about playing your synths. It's a little early for me, so let's go to wrench tool, time shift it a bit. It's modern elements, but it has that sloppiness that a lot of old school hip hop had, and it has the hardness in the drums, and that's what's creating that nice swingy thing. So now let's add the percussion, like the open hi-hat and cymbal, just for more impact. So you want to really think about changing the time shifts or the delay for each of these elements to give it a unique spot in the song. And notice how I added that open hi-hat in the middle of nowhere. Those are nice spots you can add the open hi-hat just for a little more variation, because you want to make it very unique, like it's a drum break almost. And drum breaks, we use them because they have a lot of different styles of playing the same drum kit. So that last one was a little too early. I'm going to slide that over a bit. Make sure the time is right. And there we have it. Now you have variation within your song. Let's see what else we can add. Let's see what else we picked. We don't really need that kick. Now you want to think automation. So in this part, I'm going to make the cutoff filter move over time as well. So let's browse parameters. Let's go to filter control for the cutoff. Right click, create automation clip. Now for the second half, I'm going to tell it to go down so we don't hear so much tone out of the chord plucks. We're going to tell it to go down and then come back up for the chord. Paste that value back in. So now it sounds more muffled and it has a quicker decay time because we have that mod envelope modulating the cutoff frequency. Think your kick's kind of doing the same thing, you can make it match the 808. So let's clone that kick pattern. So right here when it goes boom boom boom, let's insert pattern 3. Okay, so I'm adding that kick to layer it with the 808 just for a different variation. Now, a lot of the vocal techniques match Kanye, and we have different videos on how to get the Kanye effect at busyworksbeats.com/Mac. There you can find, we have a whole course which has the Kanye effect, the Drake vocal effect, different things you can use on the vocals to get that last touch that you really don't hear comes with that effect. Now we can try to add guitar. I'm not sure if this will fit, but at least we could try it. Let's go to Omnisphere. We're going to pull up the blues guitar. It's a nice lead sound you can use. Let's go to guitars, bluesy lead. I like to put it on solo so we can do legato style. Now if this doesn't fit, we can always leave it out, but it's always something to test just to make sure. Could fit, but it just, we don't need it. It's just extra. Now another thing you want to test is lowering the overall tempo. Quick way to do this, I mean not tempo, master pitch. Lower the master pitch down to give you a very dark kind of feel you can test out. You can also go plus. That's actually a pretty cool sound. That's actually a really cool sound. So sometimes you can just change the pitch of the whole song, and it changes the way you perceive it. And what it does is it pitches up all the drums as well. So our drums sound higher of a pitch, snare sounds higher of a pitch, and it just gives you a new view of your song. So that, really think about using that master pitch change. I use it in a lot of my songs as well. And this actually sounds like a collab between 2 Chainz, Pusha T, and Big Sean. So the next portion of this sound is to actually record in the mind of the artist. And I believe all 3 of these artists can fit on this track. But that's the next step, to really get into the mind of the creative and see where they can fit in the track and understand how to utilize your own song, because hearing just the beat alone doesn't really pull out the full picture. So that's the next step in production.
Oh God. Got nothing in common, only common. Me, I'm just flying on islands, trying to get it. You just trying, you just crying, you just spying. Why? Cause you just lying. Hating on me cause they crucifying. You just want the light in me, you lucifying. My gun on me is shoot through iron at 2-2 times. Yeah, I got true, true crimes with true, true lines. Chainz came up in the rap game. Treat the rap game like the trap game. How you got a 9 and bad aim? Got my B and I put A on a map, man.
2 soldiers playing De La Rosa. Sniffing coke on the sofa. Pusher, playing my cards, no joker. But the crack on me if you a smoker. Push, A ARs in the fifth. Yeah, got bars in the fifth. Yeah, two cars, new whip. Yeah, they don't want it with this clip. Yeah, push is the main. Come through in every lane. Yeah, good music is the game. Yeah.
So thanks for watching today. If you want these project files, you want to click that link below or go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.